This is the DVO Onyx 38 SL. SL meaning super light version, and it has a conventional air spring. The service will be a little bit different if you have an OTT system. I'm gonna do a full service on this. We're gonna start off with a travel change, and I'm pulling the damper out for another video project, but I'll walk you through bleeding it. If you see any mistakes, please leave a timestamp to correct them. This video is 50% getting you familiar and 50% entertainment. Make sure you verify the official instructions from DVO. This is the SL air spring, and it's a very conventional looking air spring, and essentially changing the travel in this fork is identical to a RockShox Zeb. So if you know how to do that, you got this fork. Always start off by removing all the air and making sure the fork is completely clean before you start, because it sucks to have to clean it later on with all the oil that's gonna come out of here. This is an optional step. This is a Schrader valve tool. I like to pull the Schrader valve out just to make sure all the air is gone. If you don't have one of these tools, you should get one anyway because it's very handy. DVO is famous for making their stuff pretty darn easy to service, and this fork is no exception. This is the air spring side, and you're gonna use a cassette tool and knock that sucker loose and take it out. Now this is the damper side, and first thing we gotta do is remove the locking 2 millimeter, 2.5 millimeter Allen key out of this damper. Unfortunately, this one is extremely tight. If I turn it any more, I am for sure gonna snap the damper shaft. So you have to be familiar with bicycle parts, like you cannot force them. If you feel something with a wall of resistance, you need to stop, rethink, and look. And I'll show you the trick on how I got it off. Ideally, you have a tool that does not have serrated edges like this little pair of snap-on pliers. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna grab the low speed compression knob and clamp onto it when I'm loosening it, because essentially I'm gonna snap something inside the damper if I keep turning it. And I was able to loosen that without any damage. And let me show you why this bolt was so difficult to take off. Now skip this step, removing the damper, if you're just changing the travel. But we just have a cassette tool underneath the compression knob, and it comes out just like the air cap. The lower legs consist of an 8 millimeter Allen key, and on the damper side is a 13 millimeter. These easily come off, and the rebound knob is super simple. It just pops on with no screws. Leave 4 or 5 threads on the air spring side and hammer on the Allen key, and that will break it free. Same goes for the damper side. Put the 13 millimeter socket over there and hammer on it. Make sure you drain the lower leg oil into a catch bowl so you can check it out, because it's like looking at your own jizz. You always want to check it out when you're done. To get the air spring out of the DVO Onyx, you're going to need some snap ring pliers. This is the identical tool set to take apart a RockShox Zeb or a RockShox Domain. Easily comes out. So the lower leg service and the air spring change on the DVO Onyx is incredibly easy, and I recommend you doing this, very user friendly. The next step is I'm gonna rip the damper apart. This step is quite a bit more involved, even from the previous model DVO Onyx dampers. The DVO instructions call for 26 millimeter shaft clamps that are super rare, and there's no generic ones on Amazon. So I'm basically gonna show you how to hack your way through this, so you can change the O-rings and check the damper out and do a service or whatever else you need to do inside of this tube. The previous model Onyx, basically the bladder just sat inside the inner stanchion, but now we have this multi-piece tube that's kind of a nightmare to take apart. So on the lower section of the compression tube is a 19 millimeter wrench flat. Use that one to hold, and your 22 millimeter wrench on the top to unscrew. It is gonna feel like super stiff because they use a lot of Loctite from the factory. Once you get that apart, some of the oil will come out of the compression tube, damper tube, whatever it's called. But we have a huge problem here, okay? So this upper section is where we need those 26 millimeter shaft clamps to unscrew the top cap. Unfortunately, the Loctite is preventing me from unscrewing the top cap. So I spent about a day looking at 26 millimeter shaft clamps, and the only set I could find on the internet is $200. So after a couple hours of experimenting, I got an awesome hack to get that top cap off. If you're able to get your top cap off, make sure you press thumbs up on this video because I spent like 4 hours making this hack. Okay, this is super sketchy. We are clamping on the vise on the damper tube. As long as we're on the wrench flats and not too stiff, we can loosen it. So this is the hack here. We're gonna get a strap wrench around the 26 millimeter part of the upper compression tube and try to loosen it. So after 4 hours, success. So this compression hybrid bladder system, whatever DVO uses, looks pretty similar to the Onyx 36 I took apart a couple months ago. Maybe it's more consistent damping inside of that tube. This is a brand new bladder, so I will not be replacing O-rings, but you can follow the directions and replace all the O-rings when it's time for service. If you want to get the lower rebound section of the damper apart, you're going to get two wrenches. They provided a couple of wrench flats for you to get two wrenches on there, and basically you can do it without special tools. But keep in mind, this is pretty dangerous and kind of awkward without using the shaft clamps. So after you unscrew that green lower rebound rod out of the fork, basically you have this thing fully disassembled. There's a couple O-rings on the upper part of the compression, the damper tube, that you could replace if you wanted to. But there you have it. It looks like we got some updated rebounding inside of the new Onyx. Now, after you've replaced all the O-rings and on your full service on that bladder assembly and the rebound, or replace all the O-rings, it's time to go back together. And don't forget to look at the official instructions. And super important thing, DVO forks are super particular on oil, and that little quart costs like $20 of three-weight oil. So with the top cap off and the damper full of oil, you're going to cycle the rebound knob up and down, up and down, up and down, and make sure you get all the air out of the bottom of the fork. Now the official instructions say to just fill the damper, put it on, and then bleed it from there. I think cycling all the air out of the lower part of the damper is a better idea. I didn't film it and I don't have shaft clamps, but just do it in your hand. It's not a problem. I was kind of struggling here on the vise and I was clamping on the wrench flats as to not damage the damper tube. Once the lower part of the compression damper is bled, you're gonna put the top cap and the bladder back into the fork. I put a rag around it because it's gonna overflow and make a mess. Now you're gonna tighten up the top cap and make sure it's nice and tight. So the DVO mechanic told me to close the low speed and open the high speed compression. So basically do that with the rebound knob. Once the top cap's on, there's a bleed hole on the top of it. And I'm using that generic $20 Shimano brake bleed kit from Amazon. And I made sure it was super, super clean. Cause remember, DVO forks are susceptible to being contaminated by other fluids. So you're gonna take that bleed tool, that botched up tool, and you're gonna fill it up with oil. So basically you're gonna pull the rebound rod down and make sure the bleed funnel on the top does not suck any air in. So you're gonna add a bunch of oil to it. So now you're gonna stroke the rebound rod super, super slowly and make sure nothing gets sucked down. I was almost to the top of my funky bleed tool and this took quite a bit of while to get all the bubbles out of it. Remember, you have to move super slow to not introduce bubbles to this fluid. When do I close the bleed screw? So basically they responded back, you're gonna pull the rebound rod all the way down and you're gonna push it 10 millimeters up from the very bottom and then you're gonna put the bleed screw back in while it's overflowing. Double check your bleeding by taking the thing up to your ear and rapidly cycling it, and you can hear if there's air in it. My first time there was a little bit of air left in it and I had to redo it. So at this point it's pretty straightforward. You're just gonna bolt that compression damper back into the fork with a cassette tool. Now assembling the top CSU, the crown steer unit, is pretty easy at this point. Pop the air spring in, there's a little O-ring that seals it, put the snap ring in, And basically this thing is ready to go back together with the lower legs. So both lower legs are going to get 25 cc's of oil, 7.5 weight, but make sure you reference that chart for the official oil to not damage the seals. Now you can fully seat the lower legs, but congratulations for watching the video this far, because I'm going to teach you the best mechanic trick that nobody teaches on the internet anywhere, and it comes from an automotive background. So you need to throw your torque wrench in the trash can when you're tightening lower legs and brake fittings. So what you're going to do is you're going to fully tighten that down as hard as you physically can without breaking it, of course. And then you're going to get a hammer and you're going to hammer on the nut, the bottom two bolts of the lower legs. And then you're going to see how loose they were after I shocked them. Now, after I shocked this air spring bolt on the bottom, watch this. It is a full quarter turn loose. So do not use a torque wrench. Tighten it, hammer it, tighten it. I learned this from an old time mechanic guy. This goes for brake calipers on cars, on bikes, lower legs. Anytime we have a seal that needs to seal liquid out, we have to shock it and hammer it several times to make sure it's fully tight. And that is not in the official instructions, but it will prevent your fork from leaking and your brake calipers. So after we fully service the fork and put it all the way back together, it's time to do some dyno testing. Here's every single tool that I use to take it apart. Probably the most important one is the laptop and the vise, but they're all linked in the description. And while you're at it, click the video on the screen to compare a Suntour 38 to the DVO 38. It's no secret they're made in the same factory, but you could not believe the difference.